Literally go.
Okay, so just a little bit of an introduction.
There shouldn't be any other talking. I'm sorry. Go for
it. To the temperance movement. What happened was, as the 1800s rolled around and progressed, the people started to realize that alcohol wasn't that great. Like, I mean, they still loved drinking it and all, but especially the women really wanted their husbands to, like, be competent and be working rather than just be drunk all the time because they kept dying. So for my argumentative thesis, the temperance movement was a social reform led by women that provides a great example of continuity and change over time, brought on by the morality of the Second Great Awakening. It inspired a call for the end of alcoholism in the U.S. And this was a habit formerly thought to be completely acceptable, especially in the workplace. So for the first example of this is, this comes on a little later in the temperance movement once it really starts getting moving. This is what a family pledge would be. And basically what happens is, in here would be like the last name of the family, and down here each member would sign. And what it would say is that we as a family agree to stop using alcohol as just this, like, drinking it like we would drink water today. For my second document, we have a excerpt from a book written by Mr. Rush here, and in his book he argues that the temperance movement is a really good thing because alcohol is, like, really bad. And in this, he takes the, like, basically acceptability of different beverages to be drinking and how well they correspond with temperance and the ideas. And so as you go up the thermometer, it gets better. And the lower on the thermometer you go, the, like, worse you're getting in, like, acceptability to be drinking this stuff. And then at the bottom, he, like, speaks about spirits and liquors in and of themselves. And this is a quote from a speech that Abraham Lincoln gave on temperance itself. And this was given in 1842, so really right when the temperance movement was getting to its peak. And he said, "Although the temperance cause has been in progress for nearly 20 years, it is apparent to all that it is just now being crowned with a degree of success hitherto unparalleled. This list of its friends is daily swelled by addition of 50s and hundreds of thousands." So what Lincoln is saying here is that no longer can we call the temperance movement just, like, this thing that's going on. It's actually something that we're following and we're realizing as a society we should really be supporting this. So this is a poster that was made in the beginning of the temperance movement, and what it shows is the progression of a drunkard, basically. So you start with his first glass, then he's just casually drinking out with friends, and then it progresses to where he's drunk all the time in step five. That's him in the workforce, on his job, just sitting around a table drinking with friends. And then it shows the decline of him as a person, where he goes from poverty and disease to being outcast by his friends, and he leads to desperation and crime because he's poor and he's lonely and he has nobody but alcohol. And then finally they called it death by suicide because he's lost everything in his life, so he has nothing left. And then in the center here you see the family that he's left behind, which was really a pivotal thing for the success of the temperance movement, because the whole idea behind it was men need to stop drinking because they have women and children at home who need them. And here is another ad for the temperance movement, and basically what this says is that this is a bottle of liquor here. And inside of this, at least for the ad, is all the things you give up when you purchase that bottle. So it's 1 year's work at the top, and then inside you see all the things that alcohol has caused, like murders, criminals, murdered wives, smothered babies, suicides. It's just exemplifying all the things that alcohol does that we should really just give it up for. And this is towards the end of the temperance movement. Women really started to use their power in this as an advertisement. So women would hold up a sign like this that says, "The lips that touch liquor shall never touch mine." And basically what it's saying is, if you're drinking, you're not coming home and living with me. And so there are actually pictures of groups of women standing outside holding banners up like this. And they're all just sort of standing there. And it's just more incentive for people to stop drinking. Because, like, you can't come home to me. And here's a quote from a historian, Joseph Piper. And he says in his book, The Four... Four like, prosperous virtues, something like that. He says, temperance is selfless self-preservation. Intemperance is self-destruction through selfless degradation of the powers which aim at self-preservation. And in this book, written in the 1950s, Piper is looking back, and temperance is actually one of the four big categories in his book. And he's also a philosopher, so like, this is a really philosophical guy. And in his book, he really just speaks to like ideas of temperance more than the temperance movement itself. And just to finish this all up, the temperance movement really hasn't stopped per se, but what it leads into is like prohibition era in the 1900s. And today we still look back on these ideas and we are pretty aware that alcoholism is an issue in our society, so we can thank the temperance movement for that.
Yes.